Hi everyone, in today's session we are going to discuss about the solving of games, that is of type m by 2 using graphical method. In the previous session we already discussed about the solving of 2 by n games using graphical method. If you did not see that video, I am going to leave that video in the cards. Please watch that video. And without any late, let us get into the today's session, that is solving of m by 2 games using graphical method. So here the problem is, consider the payoff matrix of player A as shown in table. Solve it optimally using graphical method, right? So this is the payoff matrix given to us. Now we need to solve it by graphical method. So if you see the payoff matrix, the player A is having 4 strategies and the player B is having 2 strategies. So the payoff matrix is of the order 4 by 2 type. So that means the player B is having only 2 strategies only, but the player A strategies are more than 2. So that's why we are saying this model is of type m by 2, right? So first of all, let us check whether this game is having the saddle point or not. If the game is having a saddle point, then solving of game is over. But if the game is not having a saddle point, then we need to solve it by any one of the methodology. Now we are going to discuss about graphical method, right? So even though if this game is having a saddle point, we are going to solve it by graphical method. As in the problem, it was clearly mentioned that use graphical method, right? So now let us check whether this game is having a saddle point or not. So here I have rewritten the payoff matrix of the problem. So now let us find the, or let us check the saddle point. So in order to check the saddle point, we need to find, first of all, row minimum values. So now take the first row. In 1 and 3, the minimum value is 1. In 3 and 1, the minimum value is 1. In 5 and minus 1, minimum value is 5. In 6 and minus 6, the minimum value is minus 6. Sorry. In third row, the minimum value, in 5 and minus 1, the minimum value is minus 1. Right? So now we need to identify the maximum value in all the row minimum values. So in 1, 1, minus 1, minus 6, the minimum value is minus 1. So sorry, maximum value we need to identify. So the maximum value is plus 1 is the maximum value. So this one we are calling it as maxi min value. And now let us find the minimax value. In order to find the minimax value, we need to identify the column maximums. So now take the first column, 1, 3, 5, 6. So what is the maximum value in all these 4 values? It is 6. Now take the second column, 3, 1, minus 1, minus 6. In all these 4, what is the maximum value? 3. It is the maximum value. Now in these two column maximum values, we need to identify the minimum value. In 6 and 3, the minimum value is 3. So this one is nothing but mini max value. So maxi min value is plus 1, mini max value is 3. So both are not equal, and we can say that this game is having no saddle point. This game is not having a saddle point. So here the game is not having a saddle point. So now I am going to solve this problem by graphical method. So now let us solve it by graphical method. So here I am going to take, let y be the probability of selection of strategy 1 by player B. So here player B is having two strategies 1 and 2. So probability of selecting the first strategy is y I am taking. So then the probability of selecting the second strategy will be automatically 1 minus y. So as already we know that the sum of probabilities is equals to 1, that is q1 plus q2 equals to 1. If q1 is y, then automatically q2 is 1 minus y. So like this, I am taking y as the probability of selecting the strategy 1 of player B, then automatically 1 minus y be the probability of selecting the second strategy by player B. So the same things we have written here. Y be the probability for strategy 1 and 1 minus y be the probability for strategy 2. So now we need to find the expected payoff loss functions for player B with respect to the each alternative of player A. So now let us find them. So now I am going to find the expected payoff matrix of player B with respect to different alternatives of player A. So here I have constructed a table, that is with the values of A's alternative, B's expected payoff function, and B's expected loss at y is equals to 0 and at y is equals to 1. Here it is the first alternative of player A. So as already you know that this one is the payoff matrix given to us. So the first alternative of player A will be this one. So now let us find the loss function for player B for first alternative of player A. So I am going to find that. First alternative I am taking. So the probability of selecting the first strategy is already you know that y, and the probability of selecting the second strategy will be 1 minus y. So now let us multiply 1 into y plus 3 into 1 minus y. 1 minus y into 3. So then what will be the loss function? It is equals to, here it is y, here it is minus 3y. Then you will get minus 2y plus 3. Now let us find this loss function value at y is equals to 0 and at y equals to 1. Now substitute 0 here. You will get minus 2 into 0 plus 3. You will get 3. Next substitute y is equals to 1 in this function. Then minus 2 into 1 plus 3. You will get 1. Right? So now let us find the loss function for the second alternative. So what are the second alternative values? 3, 1. So now let us proceed into the same way. 3 into y plus 1 into 1 minus y. Then what you will get? 3 into y plus 1 into 1 minus y. Then here it is 3y and here it is minus y. Then we will get 2y plus 1. So now let us find the values at y equals to 0 and at y equals to 1. Substitute y is equals to 0, then what you will get? 2 into 0 plus 1, you will get 1. Substitute y is equals to 1, then here 2 into 1 plus 1, you will get 3. Right? Now let us find the loss function for the third alternative of player A. So what is the third alternative of player A? Third alternative values are 5 minus 1. This one is the third alternative, 5 minus 1. So now let us find the loss function for that. So then what you will get? 5 into y plus minus 1 into 1 minus y. 5 into y plus minus 1 into 1 minus y. What we will get? 5y. Here minus 1 into minus y plus 5 we will get. Then totally 6y minus 1 into 1 minus 1 we will get. Then calculate at y is equals to 0 and at y equals to 1. Substitute y is equals to 0 here. Then what we will get? 6 into 0 minus 1 minus 1. Then y equals to 1, substitute 6 into 1 minus 1, we will get 5, right? Now let us take the fourth alternative of player A. What are the fourth alternative values? 6 minus 6. Then what will be the last function? 6 into y plus minus 6 into 1 minus y. So now let us find them. Fourth alternative of player A are 6 into y plus minus 6 into 1 minus y. That equals to 6y. Minus 6 into minus y, you will get plus 6y. 6y plus 6y, 12y. Minus 6 into 1, minus 6. Let us find those last function values at y equals to 0. 12 into 0 minus 6. Minus 6. Substitute y equals to 1 here. Then 12 into 1 minus 6. You will get plus 6. So these are the last function values. So now we need to represent all of these last function values on the graphical method. Right? So now we need to draw a graph for representing all of these last function values. So here I have drawn a graph, and this one is the graph representing. So just like to the 2 by n games, the procedure of solving the m by 2 games is also same. As it is, no change. There we will take p as the x as the probability. Here we will take y as the probability, and the selection of region also will be different. So here I have taken two lines. First line will represent y is equals to 0, and second line will represent y is equals to 1. So now we need to represent all of these last function values on the graph. So now what is the first last function? 3, 1. At y is equals to 0, 3. At y is equals to 0, 1. So now represent 3 and 1 on the graph. So I am representing for y is equals to 0, the value is 3. And for y is equals to 1, the value is 1. So I have represented. Now draw a line by joining these two points. So if you draw a line, what we will get, how it will be means? This is the line. So this is first alternative of A, player A. A1 I have represented. Now take the second alternative. So second alternative values are 1, 3. Now let us represent them on the graph. 1 here I have taken, I have marked, and then 3 for y equals to 1. Here I have marked. So now let us draw the graph for this one. Draw a line by joining these two points. Then you will get like this. So this is the second alternative of player A, A2. Next, draw the third one. What is the third alternative values? Minus 1, 5. Let us represent them on the graph. So first, for y is equals to 0, minus 1. For y is equals to 1, it is 5. Right? Now draw the line by joining these two points. So this will is the line for alternative 3 of player A. Next, let us represent the fourth alternative values. The fourth alternative is 4. The values are minus 6 and plus 6. So now let us represent them on the graph. So minus 6 and plus 6. So I am going to represent them. Minus 6 is here, and plus 6 is here. Now draw a line by joining these two points. So now this is the line. So it will is the last function line for fourth alternative of player A. Right? So now we drawn all last functions we represented on the graph. So in the m by 2 games, first of all, there is a need to be identify the upper boundary. There is a need to identify upper boundary and then select the lowest point in the upper boundary. So first let us identify the upper boundary. So this one we are calling it as upper boundary, and this one we are calling it as lower boundary. So now let us mark the upper boundary. I am starting from here and I am moving in a downward direction. So here I need to select the path. If I move in downward direction, there will be a one alternative line above this point. So it should not be correct. So I am moving along with this line. And again, there is a cross check point will be there, whether I need to move in downward or in upward direction. If we move downward, if I select a point here, there will be one alternative line above this point. So it should not select. So I need to move in this way. And then again here the path changing point will be there, whether I move to this way or in the upper way. So we need to move in upper way so that no alternative line above this, right? And again, whether I need to move down or I need to move up, I need to move upward direction so that there will be no any alternative line. So now represent the upper boundary with a hatching. Right, so this one is the upper boundary. So in this upper boundary, first mark the intersection points. This one is the first intersection point A, this one is the second intersection point B, and this one is the third intersection point C, and this one is the fourth intersection point D. So now in A, B, C, D, we need to select the lowest intersection point. So what is the lowest intersection point? B is the lowest intersection point. Here it is, lowest intersection point. So how this point B is formed? The point B was formed because of the intersection of A3 line and A1 line. So because of intersection of A1 and A3 lines, this point was formed. So now we need to select the alternatives A1 and A3 in the strategies of player A. So here if you see the strategies of player A, we need to select first and third and alternatives only. So 1, 3, 5, minus 1 values we will get. So now let us write them. Player A, alternatives 1, 3, and player B, alternatives 1, 2. So as in the problem itself, it was given only two alternatives for player B. So now let us write the values. For first alternative, the value is 1, 3. For third alternative, values are 5, minus 1. So here it is a 2x2 game given to us. So how to solve this 2x2 game? We know that we have to solve this with the algebraic method by finding the oddments. So now let us find the oddments here. So let us find the row oddments. So what are the row oddments? The difference of 1 and 3 is 2. This difference we need to write in the bottom row. The difference of 5 and minus 1 is 6. That we need to write in for the upper row, 6. Now let us find the column oddments. So what are the column oddments? The difference of 1 and 5, 4. That we need to write below the second column. Next, the difference of 3 and minus 1 is 4. We need to write below the first column. Like this, we have find out the oddments. Then let us find the probabilities of selecting the strategies. So here the player A alternatives are 1 and 3. So we need to find the probabilities P1 and P3. So now let us find P1 and P3. So what is the P1 and P3? So for the first strategy of player A, what is the oddment? 6. By what about the sum of oddments? 6 plus 2. That equals to 6 by 8. So we will get 3 by 4. Next, take the third strategy. So the third strategy admit is 2. So now write 2 by what about the sum of admits? 6 plus 2. So that equals to 2 by 6 plus 2 is 8. And that equals to 1 by 4. Let us write the in detail probability of the player A. The probability set. So for player A, the probabilities are as player A is having 4 strategies P1, P2, P3, P4 equals to P1 probability is first strategy probability is 3 by 4. Second and fourth alternatives are eliminated. So second strategy probability 0. Third strategy probability 1 by 4. And fourth strategy is G eliminated. So the probability is 0. Right? So now let us find the probabilities of selecting the strategies 1 and 2 by player B. So now let us find them. So what are those strategies probabilities? Q1 and Q2 we need to find. So what is Q1? So first strategy admit is 4. So 4 divided by sum of admits. 4 plus 4. That equals to, we will get 4 by 8 and that is 1 by 2. Next, second strategy admit is 4. So then 4 by sum of admits, 4 plus 4. So that is also equals to 1 by 2. Now if you write the probabilities of player B, so B of, as B is having only 2 strategies, Q1 comma Q2, that equals to 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2. So we have find out the probability of selecting the strategies. Let us find the value of the game. So value of the game V is equals to 1 into 6 plus 5 into 2 by sum of admits 6 plus 2. So write it 1 into 6 plus 5 into 2 by 6 plus 2. Then it will be equals to 6 plus 10, 16 by 6 plus 2, 8. So V is equals to 2. So the value of the game is equals to 2. And also we have find out the probabilities of player A and player B. So like this, we need to solve the M by 2 games using graphical method. The only difference is in a 2 by N games, we will take the lower boundary highest point. But in M by 2 games, we will take upper boundary and lowest point. And that is the only difference we are going to do in between the two cases. So I hope you understand this problem. If you understand, please like this video and also subscribe to the channel and share this video. Thank you.